Hi everyone, this is Steve. Today let's go through legal problem 1657, determine if two strings are closed. Let's take a look at the problem first. Two strings are considered closed if you can attain one from the other using the following operations. There are two operations. One is you can swap any two existing characters. For example, A, B, C, D, E, you swap B and E. That is going to become A, E, C, D, B. Okay, this is operation one. Operation two is that you can transform every occurrence of one existing character into another existing character and do the same with the other character. For example, we can do AACABB into BBCBAA. That means we can transform all of the A's into B and all of the B's into A, right? AA becomes BB and A becomes B and BB becomes AA, right? This is operation two. It says you can use the operations on either string as many times as necessary. And given two strings, word one and word two, return true if word one and word two are closed and false otherwise. All right, for example, if ABC and BCA, are these two words closed? The definition of closed is defined above. So we can apply operation one twice. So we swap B and C. Okay, so BC becomes CB. And then we swap A and B. So BCA becomes BCA, right? And then this is the ending word BCA, which is exactly word two. That is why we're saying word one and word two, these two words are closed. Now let's take a look at example two. Word one is A and word two is AA. This is impossible to attain either word one from word two or word two from word one or vice versa in any number of operations because the frequency, they are just not equal, right? Word one has A, lowercase a appears once, and word two has lowercase a appears twice. One and two, the frequencies are not equal. There is no way that we can apply any number of these two operations to make these two words become one another, right? So that is why we are returning false here. Example three, we can take a look, CABBBA and ABBCCC. We can attain word two from word one in three operations. We can do these three operations. So, and also there's example four. Constraints here is word one and word two, they contain only lowercase English letters. The length of these two are within this range. So what does this mean to us? This means, let's just take a look at this example three. This might give us a better understanding. What does operation one mean? We can swap any two existing characters. That means the order of every single lowercase English letters within the two given words don't matter anymore, right? Because we can swap any two existing characters. That's what operation number one means. Okay, number two means that we can transform every occurrence of one existing character into another. That means as long as we can find a matching frequency of the corresponding character, right? So what that means, let's take a look at example three. This is a better example. So here, CABBBA. Okay, so BBB. So this B appears three times. Do we have anything that in, okay, this is the one that we should be looking at. BBB, this B letter appears three times. Is there anything, any letter that appears three times in the second word? Yes, there is one, CCC, right? And then we need to check the frequencies of the other letters. So AA, A appears twice. Is there any letter in word two that appears twice? Yes, BB appears twice. And there's C that appears once. Any letters that in word two that appears once? Yes, A. All right. So that is why we say this word two and word one, they are closed based on the definition of this problem. So only a couple things that we need to do, actually. Number one is that we need to make sure that every single letter that appears in word one does appear in word two. That's one way that we can do the swap, right? Otherwise, if say this one has a letter Z, however, word two has all of the matching frequencies, but it doesn't even have a letter Z. Which one can you swap with? Nothing that you can swap with, right? So that's number one. Number two is that we need to make sure that all of the frequencies, they do match. So for example, all of the frequencies of these letters, we can apply a sorting algorithm to make sure that they are sorted in ascending or descending order. And then we can compile the frequencies of the two letters in each of the words. If they are a match as well, that means we can do the swap. We can do number two operation. We can swap we can transform every occurrence of the existing one character into another, right? So that is the key to understand this problem, is basically the order of the letters of the two words don't matter anymore. And second is that we want to make sure that all of the unique characters, all of the unique letters in each of the two words, they do exist in the other one. As long as these two conditions meet, we can safely return true for this problem. I hope this makes sense. If that does, let's put the idea into the actual code. Let's see. So first, we can have, we'll just call it counts one. We'll have two simple integer arrays to denote the number of frequencies of each of the letters in the two words. And this is, since it says it's going to be lowercase English letters only, and then we'll just initialize to be a length of 26. So we'll do the same for counts two. So next, we want to make sure all of the unique characters in each of the two words, they are a match. So we want to have two hash set character set one new hash set, and we'll have, I don't need this. Let me close this off. How do I close this? All right, here you go. Now we need another one, which is set two. Now we just need two loops to loop through this word one. So first we do the counts one. This will give us the frequency, all of the frequency of each of the letters in each of the two words. And then we'll add each of the every single unique character into this set. So the set is going to give us the uniqueness. And then we'll do the same for the second word. Counts two and set two. So after this, what we want to do is that we want to sort both counts one and counts two, so that three maps to a three, two maps to a two, if it's possible. Two. And then in the end, what we can do is we'll just return whether all of the sets contain exactly the unique characters of the other set, and all of the sorted counts one and counts two, they are a match as well. If that is the case, we can simply return these two strings are closed. All right, let's do this. Set one equals set two, and for array equals, we want to use equal. This is the API in this class, counts one and counts two. All right, now let me run a code. Interesting, I got a compile error for each not applicable. Oh, all right, two char array. I forgot to call this, it won't recognize this. All right, submit again. What is this? Cannot find symbol. Equals arrays equal. What is wrong with this? I believe this API is wrong. It should be equals. All right, this should do the job. All right, accept it. Now let me submit it and let's see. All right, it does get accepted. Success, 47 milliseconds. Let me just submit it again. And there isn't any big difference. All right, but anyway, this is the idea of the solution to this problem. I hope it makes sense. And if you have any comments, questions, please comment down below in the comment section. I really appreciate it. I hope it makes sense to you guys. If that is the case, please do me a favor and gently tap the like button. That's going to help me a lot and help out with the YouTube algorithm. I really appreciate that. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel, as I have accumulated quite a lot of different lead code tutorials, data structure, algorithms, or even Amazon Web Services. How do you pass Amazon Web Services certificates? All of those cool videos. Feel free to check them out. Hopefully I'll just see see you guys in just a few short seconds in my other videos. Thank you very much for watching. See you guys in the next one.